Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is DaskCube. DaskCube is functionally equivalent to linked cubes by Evgeny Grigoriev. So when he invented his puzzle, it gave me the inspiration for that one. The special property about his puzzle is that there is a set of cubes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, these 7 cubes, they always stay together when turning the puzzle. And he implemented his mechanism externally, so having edges stick out and bump into each other. And one of the things that I didn't like is that it gave overshoot. So my solution is to have the mechanism actually inside the sphere, and the mechanism makes sure that when you make a turn, for instance like this, here it blocks. You can't go any further, you can go back. But you can't go any further. You can go to here, and from here, for instance, we can make this move. But here, again, it blocks because the mechanism at the inside blocks. And then, okay, let's start and scramble. You can make a U shape, and then in another direction, and then turn it again into that shape. And well, you see, like a Rubik's Cube, it gets quickly scrambled. And it's nice to play, because the shape, all of these cubies, they always stay together. So, how did I do this? Well, let me show you the mechanism at the inside. So, what you see at the inside is just a 3x3 Rubik's Cube mechanism with edges and with corners like these. So we have edges and corners, and what you see first of all is that the corners with external cubes, they look different from the other ones. They have they are more hollow, so they have more freedom of movement. Also the edges, they are different. You see here there is an edge without a QB, and this is an edge with a QB. And I hope you can see the difference in the cross section. This one has a little flange and some space there. And actually the three edges, they are different. Edge number one has the extra space on top. Edge number two has the extra space here. And edge number three has it below. And when one edge moves along the other edge, they don't interfere with each other. I hope you can see it. So edge number one can pass edge number two. Edge number two can pass edge number three, like this. And these also can pass each other. However, if we have an edge of this type, it cannot pass, it blocks. So this way the mechanism was implemented, and at the outside you don't see anything because the mechanism is completely internal. So my question to you is about the name of this puzzle. I called it DaskCube. Why did I call it DaskCube? What is it named after? Thank you for watching.